was for entertainment purposes only. And if you want true legal advice, contact your own lawyer.
You know where there's money in football? Where's their money in football? Yeah. Come on. Now, Todd does do some baseball commentary.
I mean, do.
He will do for some minor league baseball teams. He is the commentator for it. But where there's money in football, in especially the college football, is the TV rights.
That's right.
And the Mountain West Conference, those of you who don't know or from the East Coast, the Mountain West Conference, the biggest team is Boise State. Boise State's got a huge football program. They're usually ranked in the top 25. But it's Boise State, Colorado State, San Diego State, Utah State, Air Force, Nevada, San Jose State, Hawaii, Wyoming, UNLV, Fresno State, and New Mexico.
And for those of you that might not know what Boise State is, if you've ever seen a college football game played on a blue field. Right. It's not green, it's blue.
Smurf turf.
That's right. That's Boise State.
Yes, but they're a phenomenal football team. And so what do they want? They want more money, because what happens, those of you who don't follow sports, it's very interesting to see the dynamics of, like, the Mountain West conferences. Believe it or not, Boise State gets more money of the TV revenue than the rest of everybody else, because they say we're the ones that bring in the revenue, like the West Coast Conference. Who has ever heard of the West Coast Conference? Those of you in the East Coast listen to us, the Midwest, you're going, who? Now I'm going to say a name, and you're going to know who the West Coast Conference is. What's the name?
The Mountain West Conference.
Gonzaga.
Gonzaga.
Oh, no, I mean West Coast Conference.
Yeah, yes, Gonzaga.
Gonzaga. Gonzaga basketball. In fact, they were number one. Now they're the number two basketball team in the nation. Pretty much that's all people know is
that's
the
right.
West Coast. BYU's in there, St. Mary's, which are good. But, you know, you talk to people in the East Coast and in the Midwest. Do you know who the West Coast Conference is basketball? Huh? Do you know who Gonzaga is? Yes. And so Gonzaga came to the West Coast Conference and says, we're leaving unless you, for all this money that is coming across for the TV rights, we want a bigger percentage.
That's right. And arguably, Boise State has a beef, and why they want to leave to get money has to do with something that ESPN was doing in broadcasting your games that increased the likelihood that folks on the East Coast never saw the games.
And what was that?
Well, the start time for these games that when ESPN would play them was 8:30 p.m.
Mountain time, right.
Well, that is
11:30.
Well, if it's 8:30 Pacific time, it's 11:30. It's 12:30.
Right.
That's right. So it's 11:30 on the East Coast.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, who's going to stay up to watch a game that starts at 10:30, 11:30?
Right.
For a team that is iffy as far as what they know, they're all going to go to sleep, because they have to be to church the next morning.
And especially, by the way, not a potential recruit or a potential sponsor, which is why they like having these nationwide games. Besides the sponsorship money you talked about, recruits see those games and they say, oh, man, I want to wear that uniform.
That's exactly right.
I mean, it does
right.
happen. It happens all
That's
the time.
That's exactly right. So they basically come to an agreement. In January, Boise State claimed a breach of contract with the West Coast Conference, and apparently was bringing lawsuits against them, and they're trying to work this thing out. And part of working it out is who is going to get what amount of money from the new agreement with CBS Sports and Fox Sports, which now is going to allow them to play them in an earlier time, so even people in the East Coast and the Midwest can watch them.
Now, to a certain extent, I would say that Boise State is sort of, to use a football analogy here, taking a page out of the playbook from Brigham Young University,
yep.
Who was it maybe up to 10 years ago? BYU used to be in, well, they were in the Mountain West Conference. They were in the WAC, the Western Athletic.
Right.
They've been in various conferences.
Right.
And then they decided to go independent. And when they did, they were able to negotiate their own deal with ESPN, because they didn't have to be part of a conference deal. And so they had
football
this
only,
for football only, and they had this independent deal where they would then negotiate with different teams, which allowed them to play more games against other nationally ranked teams, because they didn't have to fill up their schedule with what, at least 8 of the games or whatever against conference opponents.
Right. And Notre Dame's independent too. And the reason they do that is the money.
Exactly.
ESPN pays BYU these big monies, and Notre Dame gets big money, so that's why they stay independent.
There's
and there's only a few other independent. I think Liberty's independent.
Exactly.
And is Army? I think Army's the other independent.
They might be. So there are a couple ways they get money. One is from the TV deal for the season, and then the other big way that these programs get money is the bowl game that they go to. You ever wonder, when I was a kid, it seemed like there were only a few bowl games, you know, the Rose Bowl, those, but now there's every type of bowl game that you can imagine, you know, the Humphreys Kitty Litter Bowl and all this kind of stuff. Well, the reason these teams go is because they get money for going to the bowl game, and right. That goes into their program.
And there's another factor about that, and Fred knows this very well, and that is that some teams in college football parlance travel well, meaning that if they have a lot of fans that travel with them, and if they get a part of the cut, even on the road games, if they bring along a whole phalanx of home fans that pay that full admission price, they get a cut of all of that money flowing back to them as
well. Well, clearly, Brigham Young University and Notre Dame have a fan base. I don't care if Brigham Young University is playing in the East Coast, or they're playing Midwest or West Coast, they're going to have a huge fan base and television base that's going to follow them, whereas in the same with Notre Dame. And so what happens? ESPN wants to pay for that because they're going to get good advertising out of it.
Now, the thing that allowed BYU to do that also was because the school had also spent a lot of money in their broadcast department to create a state-of-the-art, completely HD digital facility, so that when they signed that contract with ESPN, ESPN came in and they were like, you guys have more equipment than we do. So in order for other schools to do that, they really have to beef it up. I don't know what Boise State did, but that's the direction things are headed.
Well, they don't have any money. They're painting their blue turf every day.
Exactly.
They've got the spray cans. They got spray cans piled up everywhere.
Well, when ESPN goes on the road, they rent a production company
right.
to cover that game for them. So BYU says, we got you covered.
That's exactly
right. So they're smart. So they do that. Yeah. So what's going to happen with Boise State? This is going to be interesting. It's just starting. I believe the lawsuit, I got to double check, but it's kind of put on hold at this point, I think. But I'm going to double check. Don't look it up. And they're already saying they're going to pay them a substantial more of the revenue, which includes, I believe, $5 million extra on top of what the other teams get. But don't forget. Remember, when the bowl game happens, say your Boise State's in a bowl game, not only do they get money for the bowl, they have to share part of that bowl money with the rest of the conference teams, where when BYU or Notre Dame or like Liberty, they get 100, they get it all. They don't
yep.
share it.
And
so
let's not get the famous Potato Bowl played in Boise, woo-hoo! Idaho on the Smurf turf.
On the Smurf turf. But anyway, that's lawsuits are going to be flying, possibly.
Wow.
Boise State might be leaving. We don't know. We're going to watch that when we come back.
Go to the website, radiolawtalk.com. That's radiolawtalk.com.